We're shaking people. Back with another reaction. Back for the final tune on ABBA's 1978 album, The Album, and the final song of the mini musical, The Girl with the Golden Hair. I'm really looking forward to this. It seems like most people enjoy all three tunes, but I did see some comments that one or the other of the first two maybe weren't people's favorite, despite the fact that they do like them on some level. But it seemed unanimous in the comments that I'm a Marionette is really the track of, you know, memorable standout quality of the three. So I'm really looking forward to this. It's an interesting phrase. It immediately makes me think that after making the decision to set out and to seize the opportunity and try to find a place to bring her gift and her talents to the world, things don't perhaps play out exactly as she hoped. Perhaps she ends up feeling less like she has control over how she's singing and what she's singing, but people are sort of, you know, pulling her strings and making her do things that she, you know, perhaps didn't envision as part of this journey into music, to the point where she's essentially, you know, I have to make this appearance and this person is telling me I gotta do this and they're not letting me write my own music. To the point where one would feel like you really have no control over the very thing that you wanted to be your own. So just in the title and given the context of the first two scenes of the mini musical, it really is a powerful song title. Even without the sense of the mini musical, I feel like the general sense would be the same. The idea of feeling like other people are making decisions for you or putting you into situations that you would not choose if you had your own ability to make choices and influence your own career. So yeah, it feels like someone who, despite setting out with the best intentions and, you know, with the best of hope, has come to realize that the real world is more complicated. The music industry is perhaps not as willing to let a young girl with a great voice and golden hair, you know, define her career in her own way. So, again, I know people were saying this is roughly sketched around Frida's experience. You know, she left behind an earlier life to pursue her dream to be part of the world of music, and as it turns out, part of ABBA. But yeah, I don't know if that, you know, is in relation to her, you know, maybe going to Stockholm and, you know, trying to make it there, because I imagine perhaps, you know, the music industry is bigger there than in some other places around the country. So I am thinking about that going into the song. I'm thinking about the way people really did talk about this tune positively, and I'm definitely thinking about it conceptually in terms of, you know, setting out with great hope and then, you know, the gritty realities set in, and ultimately, you know, you're trying to manifest your artistic vision, but you keep feeling like other people, again, are making decisions for you. So all these things are swirling in my mind as we get to it. Let's listen. This is ABBA. The tune is I'm a Marionette, and it's from the 1978 album, The Album. But it also sounds like not everything is clear skies.
You're so free, that's what everybody's telling me. Yet I feel I'm like a non-football, pushed around refugee. Something's wrong, got a feeling that I don't belong.
Oh, I love this already. Overwhelming, suffocating. It's a bit more rock and roll than I expected. I love it.
I
percussion feels like a train, just relentless. Look at that thing. Synthesis of the strings and the guitar. An ideal end to the mini musical, which I enjoy. You know, there's different ways to tell stories. You know, sometimes it's nice to have an ending where things kind of fall into place for all the people you care about and so on, but sometimes the most powerful stories are those that are more like life, where, you know, the results are more mixed, and sometimes people who don't deserve it end up having, you know, bad things, or at least things that are not ideal, happen to them, and things don't always turn out the way you want. So it feels like it's a more realist story in that regard, which, again, knowing what I've gone through now in the last few albums from them and getting a better sense of a lot of their songwriting, it makes perfect sense that they would have a story where it's, you know, it's complicated. You know, things were exciting and there was hope and there is passion and there's talent, but there's also the realities of the way, you know, the world works, not just the music industry and business specifically, but, you know, in the adult world more generally, you know, you don't always get what you want, and things don't always turn out the way they should, and people don't even agree on what, like, should be. So, yeah, it feels very much a memorable story in that regard, so, and well told through three songs, three scenes, like three audio scenes, if you will. So, yeah, love the intensity of this one. It feels like a band at the, you know, peak, or fully feeling their creativity, taking risks. You know, that really intense section, which I guess is the chorus and comes back multiple times, you know, that's, it's less accessible, it's not like immediately pop and smooth, but I love it because it's really fitting to the concept, but also the intent, like, you can feel her sense of being constricted and, you know, held by the whims of other people and so on. You could feel it in those sections. So it's really well composed and produced, again, for a change, right? So yeah, just an amazing album. Again, as I've gone through the albums, people keep saying it gets better, it gets better. It's like, okay, you know, I believe you, I'll go through it. And then I go through it and it's like, man, they weren't wrong. It's, I love what I've already heard, but that was next level. So it's the same here. Another fantastic tune. Once again, thank you to Adam for sharing all this. Thank you to everyone who's commented in the ABBA reactions, which, admittedly, it is getting to the point where I think it's more comments in the ABBA reactions than any other deep dive, including some other ones that get a lot of comments, like Aha and Duran Duran and so on. But yeah, I just can't tell you how much I appreciate the ABBA people providing insight, not only giving me their thoughts about the songs just on a technical or conceptual level, but also personal anecdotes about what their music has meant to them and their life and so on. I just love hearing these things. It's why I started talking about music and doing these reaction videos in the first place. So big ups to all of you. Let me know what you think of this one. I will see you next time. Peace.